Once the slot is large enough, I use a Christensen crown remover to separate the crown from the prep. Welcome back to part two, where I'll now take you through the prep and impression for the BruxZir Esthetic restorations that we placed on tooth numbers 7 and 10. We'll start with the removal of the PFM crowns, where I use a carbide 557 burr to create a slot through the crowns along the facial, incisal, and lingual surfaces. It's pretty easy to tell once we've cut through a PFM since the transition from metal to tooth prep beneath is pretty obvious. Once the slot is large enough, I use a Christensen crown remover to separate the crown from the prep. For more stubborn crowns like on number 10, I make an additional horizontal slot to help with the removal. Once the crowns are removed, it's time to refine the preps and also to modify the buildups if necessary. The gingival zenith on number 7 is about half a millimeter lower than number 10, so I'm just checking the sulcular depth with the probe to make sure I have enough room from the attachment to raise the margin. For all my preps, I use a round-ended tapered diamond burr to create the appropriate depth and rounded internal angles along the axial surfaces, which will result in a deep chamfer margin. For BruxZir Esthetic, we're looking for a reduction of about 0.7 millimeters along the gingival margins and a 1.5 millimeter clearance. To remove the temporary filling material on number 10, I use a carbide round burr at a slow speed. This helps ensure I don't remove much tooth structure beyond the temp material. Once I reach the gutta percha, I seal the top with Vitrobond glass ionomer. Now to start the buildup, I use Kerr's 37% phosphoric acid etch for 10 seconds, followed by OptiBond Universal. After I apply a bonding agent, I always use air and suction to remove excess bonding agent and also to evaporate the solvents. Once the bonding agent has been light cured for 10 seconds, I incrementally use camouflage nanohybrid flowable composite so the buildup is well adapted to the teeth. Once the buildups are cured, I'll continue refining the preps to ensure that there is adequate reduction and the internal surfaces are rounded and smooth.